Okay. Ready? Open your Bible to 1 Kings chapter 21. Go ahead, fellas. 1 Kings chapter 21. Now, all the little bitty ones are gone now, so y'all, rest of y'all, can behave now. Don't talk. 1 Kings chapter 21, and I want to read tonight with verse 20. 1 Kings chapter 21, and look at verse 20. And Ahab said to Elijah, "Hast thou found me, O mine enemy?" And he answered, "I have found thee, because thou hast sold thyself to work evil in the sight of the Lord." Good night. What a statement. Look at verse 25. "But there was none like unto Ahab, which did sell himself to work wickedness in the sight of the Lord, whom Jezebel, his wife, stirred up." Two times in that scripture, it says that this man, Ahab, sold himself. Was that really possible? When you saw the title of the sermon tonight, many of you thought that I was probably being just a little bit overdramatic or overboard, and I was not. There are people, as you'll see tonight, that literally had said, "Devil, I'll make a deal with you. I'll make a deal with you. If you'll let me be famous and popular and get rich and have money and drugs and party, I'll give you my soul." You say, is that possible? Sure is. Absolutely. You can make a pact with Satan. I'll show you that tonight. Now, you're going to be shocked at what you're getting ready to see. With about the first two-thirds of the message tonight, some of you will be familiar with, then the rest of it, this will be the first time. I want you to give me your attention tonight as I introduce the message. I want to say that everybody, we're all affected by music. I love music. I've loved music my whole life. What we like really is not important. People say, "Well, I just like it." Well, that don't mean nothing. What should mean something is, does God like it? Is it wrong? Is it right? Who does it glorify? The Bible said that a Christian should speak to themselves in psalms and hymns and spiritual songs, singing with grace in your heart, making melody to the Lord. Well, Christian, I mean, my goodness, people, think about it tonight. All of us, I mean, I grew up with a song on my mind. My mom sang all the time. I sang all the time. When I was playing in a rock and roll band when I was about 13 years old, and 12, 13, 14, and I've had a song on my mind every day of my life. I wake up in the morning, there's a song playing in my head. I go to sleep at night, there's a song playing in my head. I don't know if you're like that or not. Sometimes it's a song I don't even like. And sometimes I'll go in a store, buy something to drink, pack of crackers, 5 miles down the road, I'm singing this song. Well, where did I hear that? And it was in that store back there, just for a minute. Word for word. It's a very powerful force. You can change the whole atmosphere of a crowd by the music. You know that. A lot of people say, "Well, you can't, you know, music's music and music is neutral." That's not true. There's good music, there's bad music. I can show you in the Bible where this a demon came on Saul, and the Bible said David came in and played. He had a harp like this, and he just go bring, and he'd play a song, and that evil spirit would leave King Saul, would leave him. So there's certain kinds of music that makes evil spirits leave. And the Bible also said that one place where a man played the music, that the hand of the Lord came upon him. So God's hand and power settles in on certain kinds of music. And you know as well as I know, if good music can bring in God's spirit, bad music brings in the devil's spirit. You know that. You know that. Some of you teenagers sitting here tonight, your head and heart is so full of sin and iniquity. And you don't do drugs. You don't drink liquor, most of you. You don't do that. But it's the music. It you can get high off of it. It's a proven fact now. On the internet, they're saying that you can get addicted and you also get a high, a euphoria, just off of music. They call it digital drugs. And tonight, I have some things to show you and tell you about that. I want to read in a minute just a word or two of a song and just show you something. This song is called Rock God. It's by a little girl named Selena Gomez. And Selena Gomez is just a young, just teenage girl. I reckon, but this song was written by Katy Perry. And the name of this song is Rock God. Just listen to the words of this song. What this song, what Selena Gomez is saying is, I am in love with the God that gave me this music. That's Satan. Listen, preacher man walked into the club and said, hey girl, can't you walk and not stray? Father, I'm torn and I'm selling my soul. That's what Selena Gomez said. This little girl who's Justin Bieberhead's girlfriend said, I'm selling my soul. That ain't a joke, people. That's not nothing to mess around with. Listen, she said, I'm selling my soul to the rhythm, to the beat, and to the bass. Because I ain't confessing my rock and roll ways. I'm so possessed with the music. The music he plays. Yeah. It's not neutral. It's not I like it. It's his music. Yeah. I can't stop my feet from dancing to the sound of his drum. Oh no, I fell in love with my rock God. Wonder who that is. I can't keep my hips from swaying to his sweet melody. You see, I fell in love with my rock God. Preacher took my hand, looked in my eyes. He said, hey girl, can't you live your life right? She said, a preacher said, get right, just like I'm doing to you tonight. And she said, it's not like I'm hurting anyone. My rock and roll ways, I can't confess. No, I wouldn't change a thing even if I could. She said, I wouldn't change it even if I could, and I can't. Don't doubt it. When those kids get famous and they get on Big Shot and they get a hit with music and all, they made a deal somewhere back there somewhere. Yeah. You don't get just famous overnight for no reason at all. And I'm going to tell you, just like God can get a hold of a preacher out in the woods on his knees and anoint him to preach, God gets a hold of people, or the devil gets a hold of people who yield their life to him and anoints them to sing. Yeah. She said, I wouldn't change a thing even if I could. I can't, but if I could, I wouldn't change it, because I chose a path and I'm not looking back. How old is she? 16? 17? Think about that. Think about that tonight. Now, we all love music. You can change the atmosphere of music. I hear people all the time say, well, music don't matter, Brother Danny. Oh, really? Really? Well, I can make you feel certain ways. I can make you think certain things just by changing music here tonight. I've thought about lots of times. I've thought about many, many times how that young people don't realize how that you can just set the whole mood. Watch this. Watch this tonight. Let's just say, now watch me set the mood in here this evening. Here we go. Walking home through a graveyard. It's real, real dark. We had one fall out on the floor right there. You see that music? That's what that does. Now I'm going to tell you, brother, you can. How do you know when you're watching a movie, you know if they took the music out of the movies, it wouldn't even be worth watching? How do you know when the killer's coming? The music tells you he's coming, right? You know, she comes in the house and she, you know, she's always taking a shower. Why do they always take a shower? Everybody gets killed in the shower. Them perverts in Hollywood got to have everybody getting killed in the shower. If I lived in Hollywood, I'd never take a shower. Because as soon as you get in that shower, somebody going to come in there with a knife and stab you to death. Okay, she's in there. She's getting in the shower. She's getting in the shower now. The killer. That ain't right, is it? You don't kill somebody that music. That's not kills people in the shower music. And people say, well, it don't matter, Brother Danny. It really don't matter. I mean, it don't matter what you, it don't matter, Brother Danny. It's just like, well, it don't matter, you know, it's just all music. Well, whatever. Listen, let's say the Pope comes out to make a speech. The Pope of Rome. I mean, he's got his dress on, grapefruit on his head. Dressed like mama, claims to be papa, I ain't even married. He comes out to make a speech. Here he is, the holy pontiff, making his speech. And now here he is, ladies and gentlemen. There he goes. Wonder what would happen if the Pope came out to make his speech and it sounded like this. That's a weird way for a Pope to make a speech. That's a strange way for the Pope to make a speech. But wonder if this, wonder tonight if you were running. And you were running from that guy in the graveyard that lives in the graveyard. He's after you. And you're going through there and you're running around those trees. The trees. See? See, he's after you. It's like that right there. Isn't that right? Sure. You know that. Y'all ain't as dumb as you act like you are. Let's just say this. Here we are out here, and we're going to see the WWWWW, and they're all going to fight. And these are the biggest, baddest guys in the country. And these big, bad guys are baddest in the country, and they come out here, and their muscles are that big, and they come out here, you know, they come out here, and they're going to fight, you know. And here's the music as they get ready to walk down the ramp and fight each other.
It's a hard knock life for us. It's a hard knock life for us. Better treat it.
No, don't think so. I don't think so. Let's just imagine, me and Damien over here, we went to rest home the other day. Went visiting a little bit. You know, in the rest home, there's an atmosphere in an old folks' home. We went in there the other day. And there's these sweet, dear little ladies. And they were sitting there about 80 years old. And they were so sweet. Their face just shined. They were sitting there like that, you know. And they are out there. You could just feel this atmosphere around there. They were so sweet. And I said, how are y'all today? It's so good to see you. And you could just feel this when you saw them. Oh, people get into that. You know, football started. Did anybody go to the football game last night? Anybody? Or Friday night? Well, we got several here. Went to the football game. I don't know if the Freedom High Patriots or the Patton Pugs or whatever they are or any of these teams come out. But boy, I'll tell you, if they come out, they're ready to play the first football game of the season and they're ready to come out. Here they are, ladies and gentlemen. Freedom High School or whatever high school, or McDowell High School or Shelby High School or Hickory High School. Let's bring them on. They're ready for their first game of the year. Here they are, ladies and gentlemen, the football team. Right. Now, you can't play football to that. It's impossible. That is not, you can't play football to that. You'd be tripping, falling down, you know, and everything. You know what you play football to? You play football. Knock him in the head. That's what you play football to. You do not play football to Chinese music. It don't work. Boys and girls, you know that. And you argue with your mom and daddy. And you say everything in the world. And you try to tell them, well, mommy, it don't matter. Music's music. And my music's my music. And your music. Well, I tried all that stuff. It don't work. You know this song called Like Amazing Grace? Somebody says, Amazing Grace, how sweet the sound. I will say the same words and just do something like, it don't matter, music's music, and my music, and your music, I tried all that stuff, it don't work. You know this song called Like Amazing Grace? Somebody says, amazing grace, how sweet the sound. See that? Now I'm going to say the same words and just do something like, amazing grace, how sweet the sound. People say music don't matter. You're retarded too. It sure does. And it don't have to be. I mean, I just made that up just now. I was going to do something. Listen, you don't know. You don't never know. You can tell. You turn something on the radio now, Lord, you don't know what you likely listening to. Right, Miller, say Jesus. Amen. That ain't going to work. That ain't going to work. Those songs, we was playing with them at Bible school, and we were singing, and he's going, watch them. Of course. Well, you see that feeling you're feeling here tonight? Just completely changed your attitude, just like that. And that ain't even rock and roll like so nowadays. Listen, brother, you can play at Sunday school compared to what they got now. Yeah, right. Amen? Yeah. So I'm preaching tonight on the subject, they sold their soul for rock and roll. Are you listening? Tonight I want to show you, and we're going to go by introduction to the video portion of the message, and I'm going to show you some things I believe that God will use to speak to your heart if you'll pay attention. Don't fight the Lord. The Lord knows what's best for you. There's some of you sitting right here tonight, and you're going to say, he's not going to get to me. I'm not going to let this get to me, because I know if I can just hold out and make it through this, I'll enjoy tomorrow and I'll enjoy this week. He's not going to get my... I'm not after your music. I couldn't care less. Music is not the issue. The issue is your soul and whether you're going to heaven or hell. That's the issue. If you're right with God, you'll clean up your musical habits. If you want to get saved and go to heaven, that's the main thing here tonight, is getting saved and going to heaven. Now tonight I want to show you something here this evening, and we'll run through this quickly. I know you got school tomorrow, and we'll go through it very quick, but I want to show you something here. We have so much violence in schools tonight. We had 8 school shootings in 2 years. In 2 years, there were 8 incidents in this country of boys and girls who were shooting themselves. There's one right there, I'll show you him again in a second, who shot their classmates in school. Now you watch this tonight, ladies and gentlemen, and let me show you something. What we're going to see here tonight is a person would literally sell their soul. You believe that's possible? It sure is. What happened in the school shooting? The boys at Columbine High School sold out, and they made a pact with the devil. Go ahead, brother, get them all. And they killed 13 students and teachers, and then took their own lives. So you watch carefully tonight as I show you this. I hope God will use it to speak to your heart. Listen to this man at the MTV Video Awards.
Music is a magical gift. Let's not forget that the arts are a compelling solution to teen violence. They're certainly not the cause of it.
Good evening, everyone. The reaction of so many people today was, oh no, not again, another high school.
The guy at the table right next to me and her, and maybe shot him.
Our schools are turning into killing fields. And after 8 school shootings in 2 years, many wonder, how could it happen again? Why is this happening?
What are the answers?
Now, what they're saying is, why are kids going to school and blowing their classmates' head off? You'll see the answer on Dylan Klebold's shirt. KMFDM, that's the acrostic name of his favorite rock band. And they have a song, the rock band has a song on you in the schoolyard getting ready to kill. And it instructs them how to shoot their classmates. Ladies and gentlemen, it's very obvious why this is happening. The rock group Pearl Jam had a video called Jeremy, where a little boy comes in the classroom and murders all his classmates right there in front of everybody.
The question...
Watch it. Why is this happening? 13 people died. Look at that. If I had a shotgun, I'd blow myself to hell. This is his song. Listen, you'll hear it again. If I had a shotgun, I'd blow myself to hell.
Why is this happening? Why is this happening?
They're certainly not the cause of it. Not the cause of it.
Why, he's crazy. They sure are the cause of it. They sure are the cause of it. They took this little girl here. She's 14 years old, Rachel Scott. They said, "Do you believe in God?" She said, "I sure do." And they said, "All right, well, go be with him." And blew her brains out. That little girl was a modern-day martyr, ladies and gentlemen. We'll see that little girl when we get to heaven at the feet of Jesus, worshiping him and being there forever. Thank God she had enough guts and faith to give her life for what she believed in. And boys and girls, when you go back to school tomorrow, stand for the Lord Jesus Christ. No matter how much it costs you, he's worth it. He stood up for you. Thank God. Stand up for him. He'll bless you for it. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. I tell you what, that little girl's gone to heaven and standing for the Lord. Watch it tonight and see.
How
that cowboy, devil without a car, devil without a car.
Kid Rock says he's a devil without a car.
Amen.
Watch him, what he said. I spend my time smoking pot, drinking beer, and killing brain cells, dropping LSD and blowing cocaine. Eminem has a demon called Slim Shady. And this demon, Slim Shady, channels his songs. He's so stupid, he don't even realize where it's coming from. It really, he's a dumb person, and he don't realize that Satan is channeling his songs to him. And the kids don't know either. They just think, man, it sounds cool. Man, I like it. Makes me feel good. You'll hear him as he talks about choking his wife to death and throwing her in the river.
Now, please, 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 please.
See, the whole song's about throwing your wife in the river and choking her to death. And we wonder where the violence in our society comes from. He said, kids, look at me like I'm a god. I'd be lying if I said I wasn't a role model. Look at what he said. The South Warren Street kids say, he's our Christ. We party in his name. You know what he said? They're into hurting themselves. They're cult people, devil worshipers. They say, I'm right next to Satan in their thoughts. His followers say, Satan is number one, Eminem is number two. You see, you're playing around with something bigger than you are, young people. You're messing around with powers and forces. And he said this. Watch it. Tonight, you're just going to see some stuff. He said, follow me, do exactly what the song says. Smoke weed, take pills, drop out of school, kill people and drink. Hear it again.
Drink, follow me, do exactly what the song says. Smoke weed, take pills, drop out of school, kill people and drink.
Yeah. Here's Christina Aguilera. She keeps singing that song about being a genie in a bottle. Watch here. These little girls want to be just like her. That age right there, emulating every word she says, saying everything she says, doing everything she does as a role model for our young people tonight.
Baby, there's a price to pay.
You see them little girls, what are they, 10, 11, something like that? She said, if you want to be with me, baby, there's a price to pay. I'm a genie in a bottle. You got to rub me the right way. That's 10 years old. And I'll guarantee you the kids in this church know that song. She ain't no genie in a bottle. She's a hoe in a jug. Amen. Preach it, brother. That's right. I'm going to tell you here tonight, ladies and gentlemen, you hear me? Listen, these are no role models for our young people. There she is kissing the dog. Watch this. Music said this. He said, music directly represents the passion and states of the soul. Gentleness, anger, courage. If one listens to the wrong kind of music, he'll become the wrong kind of person. You know when that was said? 1340. Wonder what the wrong kind of music was in 1340. Lord, help. Tonight, watch it, ladies and gentlemen. You hear me? Marilyn Manson said, as a teenager, I was very interested in selling my soul. So he makes a deal with the devil, and then the devil makes him famous. The devil says, you give me your soul, I'll make you famous. Watch him as he's saying. He's standing behind a pulpit. You see the satanic S. The satanic S. Looks like a lightning bolt. Kiss. All of these groups have that same satanic S. Jesus said, I beheld Satan as lightning fall from heaven. That's where that comes from. He's standing there behind the pulpit with a suit and a tie on, with a Bible at a concert. Watch him as he rips the pages out of God's holy word and throws it to the crowd like they're an angry mob of wolves. Look at that. You feel that spirit? Buddy, that's opposite of what we got in here. Ladies and gentlemen, what you're seeing there is a satanic worship service. Amen, sir. Why not take an encyclopedia? Why not take Shakespeare? Why not take the Koran? The Bible, the Bible, the Bible, God's book, God's holy word, and ripping the pages out of it. Listen, our forefathers bled and died so we could have this book. They died so I could have that book. Brother, they laid their life down so we could have it. And then this reprobate gets up there and tears it. Some of you kids need to make up your mind whose side you're on anyway. I ain't on his side, I can tell you that, brother. I'm on the Lord's side. I don't know whose side you're going to be on, but you're going to be on the losing side if you're on his side. See him act like he's throwing up? Gag. The Bible.
What do you think about him when he tears up a Bible and kind of mocks God in his stuff?
I'm all for it. I'm a Satanist myself.
Here she said, I'm all for it. I'm a Satanist myself. Oh, Ozzy Osbourne, he said, something's got a hold of me. He said, I hope it's not what I think. Satan. Black Sabbath said that many times something gets a hold of them. And they sat there in the room one night, and something came in their room. And he wrote a song about it. They usually do when that happens.
Black shape with eyes of fire.
Devil don't play fair. The devil will take that man to hell and laugh at him forever and ever and ever and ever and ever. Young people, you better wake up. You better wake up. You better. It's not a game you're playing. It ain't just like Friday night. We're going to live and then we're going to go get high. And we're gonna, that's the devil tricking you tonight. We're in a battle for your soul. We're in a battle for your soul. We're in a battle for your soul. Cream, way back years ago, Eric Clapton, them guys, said, sometimes it feels like something else is playing my instrument, and that same thing is playing all three instruments. That's what I mean, is sometimes we'll all play the same phrase out of nowhere. It happens often to us. Listen to this song.
My soul, you'll be reborn. And when you're thirsty, don't want to grab your horn.
You say, well, preacher, ain't no loud. Listen to that. What about Kurt Cobain? He said, I'll get stoned. Look what he said about God. That's why he went to hell when he was 27 years old. Well, preacher, ain't no loud. Listen to that. What about Kurt Cobain? He said, I'll get stoned. Look what he said about God. That's why he went to hell when he was 27 years old. That magic number that Jimi Hendrix, Janis Joplin, that girl just the other day on TV, he said, when I go on stage, I get possessed. Ladies and gentlemen, look at what Van Halen said. You don't have to die and go to heaven. He said, I'm going to abandon my spirit to them, demons, which is exactly what I attempt to do. You work yourself into that state and fall into supplication of the demon gods. The demon gods. Watch it tonight, boys and girls. You hear me tonight? The devil put aside a devil for them. Bon Jovi said, I'd kill my mother for rock and roll. I'd sell my soul. When I was a boy, the devil took me down. This is what the rappers say.
If thou therefore wilt worship me, all shall be thine.
Now this is Anton LaVey. He was the pastor of the First Church of Satan in San Francisco, California, till he died and went to hell on Halloween a few years ago. One of the things you have to learn how to do to be a Satanist is be able to read, speak, talk, or write backwards. And the most blasphemous thing you can do is quote the Lord's Prayer backwards. Watch them do it to blaspheme God. Like them stupid dog is love bumper stickers you see on hippie cars.
Our forgive, and bread daily our day that us give, heaven in it, as all bond done be will thy come kingdom.
Blaspheming the Bible, the Lord's Prayer.
Father our.
Listen to the rappers do the same thing, satanic.
Our Father which art in heaven, heaven and art which Father our. Our Father which art in heaven.
Now, Snoop Dogg here has a demon, a black fowl bird in the Bible is a picture of an evil spirit. He comes into his room, he materializes as the devil. You can see the snake eyes. He comes in and he takes his soul, promises him a lot of fun, but he's lying to him. Watch him through the video as he comes in and takes his soul that he gave him a long time ago for parties with girls. Watch him when you smoke pot. When you smoke pot, what you're doing, you are opening yourself up to demonic spirits. And it shows you here on the video. See, here's Snoop, here is Satan, and watch him suck the devil in with marijuana. Watch it tonight.
Since we're giving a rock award.
This is the MTV Video Awards, which I just found out they're happening tonight out here in Hollywood somewhere. Isn't that something? This was a couple of years back. The blasphemy here is a man by the name of Jack Black. You don't believe it? Parents, watch it. You think this is cool? You got a sick head. Your head's sick. And I'll tell you why. Listen to him as he leads the whole congregation in a prayer to Satan.
Tonight, who wants to pray to the devil with me? Who's in with me? Come on, hey, let me see those.
Watch this. See that right there? That's a satanic sign. I can show you on a satanic album, three fingers turned down, that denies the Father, Son, Holy Ghost. Two fingers stuck up means the horns of Satan. Now in sign language, they do it like that. It's supposed to mean I love you. But when all three of them are down and them two are up, it's saying, Hail Satan. Yeah. I don't care if it's cheerleaders. I don't care who it is. That is a satanic sign, the sign of the corona. Watch it tonight. You say, oh, he's just joking. Oh, why don't he joke about something else? Lead them in a prayer to Satan.
Let me see those horns. Metal, metal, metal.
Look at Hollywood. They know their power is coming from somewhere else.
Metal! Metal! All right. Now take the hand of the person next to you. Come on, Layton. Dear Dark Lord Satan, hope everything's good with you. I'm doing fine myself. Just want to say hi and ask you to grant tonight's nominees continued success in the music industry.
He said, Satan, we ask that you would grant tonight's nominees continued success in the ministry that they're in the industry. That means let them stupid kids in North Carolina buy all their records. That's what that means. Yeah. And make them rich while they live the high life and lead you to the lake of fire. Watch it.
How was that?
Metal. Very metal.
Thank you.
Now watch. Lady Doo-Doo gets her reward here. Watch what she says.
The best fans in the whole world, and I love you. And it's for God and for the gays.
It's for God and the gays. Nothing any worse happened than Sodom and Gomorrah, people. Before God destroyed Sodom and Gomorrah, that's what they were doing. Held that idol, that silver god up, and said, this is for God and the gay. I hate to tell her, but she got a different God than I've got. My God's not interested in that idol or the gay. Amen. He died for their sins just like he died for our sin, but he sure ain't interested in that lifestyle or those false idols. Right. Ladies and gentlemen, tonight we are in the fight of our life. We are in a war over the souls of our young people tonight. Watch this here tonight. They say, what, when they went off the air that night, they said it was a den of thieves. That's a quotation from the Bible where Jesus said, my house shall be called a house of prayer, but you've made it a den of thieves. In other words, that's opposite of church. Opposite of church. Watch. Opposite of church. They're making it clear, this is not church. Church is over there. We're over here. And I tell you tonight, I'm glad, thank God, when I was 18 years old, the Lord looked down and saved me and put me in the real church. I'm over here, they over there. I took my side with the Lord. He's the winner. He's going to win. He will win. He never loses, and you can't lose when you're on his side. Watch it tonight. Now watch this tonight, ladies and gentlemen.
Not right now. You hear my diddle in the street? I'm kind of hot right now. Come up. It sure was, buddy.
Because you'll go join the stupid club of Jim Morrison, Kurt Cobain, Tupac Shakur, Jimi Hendrix, all of those guys. The World Almanac said the average age of death is 75 in America now. The average age of rock singers, 36.9. Here's what they won't show you. You'll never see an MTV special on this. You'll never see a documentary on this. Young people, why don't they show you this? Why don't they, reality TV? Let's bring it on. They're a teen mom, and teen mom's cool, and cribs, and we're all cool. Why don't they show you? This is what happens when you go to a party and you drink and then you have sex with somebody you don't even know is clean or not and you get a disease. This is a teenager's face. This is syphilis. 70,000 new cases a year, teenagers, and that's what it does to your skin. When we went to school, they taught us in health class there was 4 sexually transmitted diseases that we had to watch out for. You know how many they are now? 50. And when you lay down with somebody sexually, you are laying down with everybody they've ever touched. You better think about that. You say, it can't happen to me. That's what they thought. Why don't they put that on TV? Why don't they do a special on AIDS? Let me show you what a person with AIDS looks like. They'll never show you this on TV. Look at this boy.
I made a mistake because I had been so well taught that God was a God of grace that I could just about go out and do anything I wanted and God would...
He died not long after that. Why won't they show you that on TV, kids? Because the one that's in charge don't want you to see that. They want you to think, man, just cool, live it up, party, do what he want to, nothing ain't gonna happen. You ain't gonna have no car wreck. It can't happen to you. Let me show you what's going on tonight. This is newer stuff. Feel this spirit. This ain't like I was playing there on that guitar a while ago. This is a spirit. See the upside down crosses? The pentagram, the goat's head. That's a strange spirit there, brother. King Antichrist is the name of that song.
A very beautiful day.
is the day for the arrival.
He said the name of this song is The Arrival of Satan's Empire.
Oh, Satan's Empire!
They're looking for the Antichrist to come. Something wrong there, brother.
666 voices.
The name of that song is 666 voices in my head.
Inside.
Awesome. My.
Teach children to worship Satan.
Teach children to worship Satan is the name of this song. Listen to this.
Jesus.
Death to Jesus. The name of this song is Kill the Christian.
This, that, and the other. And every time I do an interview, they always go, what about that kill the Christians?
Kill the Christians. See the signs there with the kids' hands?
We ask our father Satan to open us.
We ask our father Satan to open the gates. Open the gates, Satan. AC/DC said a long time ago, hell ain't a bad place to be. That's a lie. That's a lie. That was way back in the 80s, kids. Way back yonder. Way back there. They said, hell ain't a bad place to be. Listen, they don't know. They've never been dead. People in hell tonight would talk to you. They'd say, yeah, hell is a bad place to be. Don't go there, young people. Give your life to Jesus. Give your life to the Lord. I want to show you something different here tonight. Watch this. Hell's bells. Hell's bells. Are you kidding? Katy Perry has a song called E.T. You felt that reaction when I put that on that screen? She has power. And the whole song is about her having sexual relations with an alien. And that's exactly where we're headed in this world. Sexual relations with demons. Genesis chapter 6 said the sons of God saw the daughters of men that they were fair. And they mixed and produced giants. I'm going to let you see just a little bit of the words of this song. This is not just boyfriend and girlfriend. This is a woman wanting a demon. It's a different DNA. Said you're a demon. They don't understand you. See, like Edward on Twilight, he's from another world. That's what's coming. They're going to open your eyes, all right. They're going to open your eyes, all right. Watch this tonight. Look at what she says to him. Don't you think it's kind of weird that almost every teenager in America can sing a song word for word about, I'm ready for abduction, I'm ready for something to come from out there somewhere. Listen, people, them things ain't coming from outer space. They're coming from hell. They're coming from inner space. And there are UFOs and they are have occupants, but they ain't from Mars. The Bible said Satan is transformed into an angel of light. That's why they said, I saw a light in the sky, I saw a light in the sky, I saw a light in the sky. And he transforms himself into an angel, and that's what Katy Perry is singing about. Getting you ready to take the mark of the beast, boys and girls. See the alien? Ain't that something? Watch this. Here's the way he gets you girls. Listen to this song called Fault by Falling in Reverse. From the depths of hell, so far I've fell. I'm told. Young people.
Lies so rock and roll, I'm my day power. Lies so rock, so rock.
seem so far away. I got to thinking the other day as I was putting this together, you're the first audience to ever see that in the context that it's being showed tonight. The first time you've ever seen, anybody's ever seen the next few minutes and what I'm showing you now. I got to thinking, what if that was one of our kids? And there's one of my girls and my grandkids that said, I made a deal with the devil. I'm gone. I'm done. I'm gone. That would be so hopeless. Just as good as in hell as if you're already there. I'm telling you tonight, by the power of the Holy Ghost, you better get right with God here tonight.
Amen.
You're messing around with something bigger than you are. You're messing around with something bigger than you are. You see that corona hand there I showed you a minute ago? Watch this. See that? That's a sign of an unholy trinity. There it is. When you see that sign right there, you see a person that is honoring Satan. Now, before this service today, I prayed. People fasted. I fasted some yesterday. People fasted for this service. I got down on my knees at home and in my office over there, and I said, God, please give me power. God, please give me power to preach. Don't you think for a second that them singers don't get power and get themselves hooked in with a spirit to give them power. I'm going to show you one here in just a minute. His name is Lil Wayne. And I'm going to show you how he's getting his power from Satan. And I'm not joking. He's anointed of Satan. Watch him. Watch this. See these signs? I'm going to show you a few of them. Look at that. Over and over and over and over. That same sign. Lord have mercy. Look at that. World leaders. Justin Timberlake, buddy. Paul McCartney. Usher. What about that? Nuthead. Anton LaVey, the pastor of the First Church of Satan. Now, Lil Wayne, as he comes on stage, it's hard to see, but he takes both hands and does this and gets into this, working himself into a state where the demon empowers him to perform. Don't you doubt it for a second. They're getting power from somewhere to come out and perform for you kids. Just like a preacher can't preach without being anointed. They can't perform without being anointed. Now, I know the devil's fighting everything I'm saying here tonight, but I'm telling you, I know I'm right. I know the Holy Ghost of God is with me, and I'm telling you the truth before God here tonight. All right, watch this. Watch it. He's going to jerk his hands back and forth like he's working himself up into a spirit to get possessed. Watch. Now, slower. Watch his left hand. Even slower. There it is! There's a satanic worship service. See them all doing that? The goat's head in the middle. You want to hear Kanye West say, sold his soul to the devil? Here you go, listen.
I sold my soul to the devil.
You want to hear it again?
Deal. I sold my soul to the devil.
Okay now, where are we going tonight? Katy Perry, you want to hear it? Do you want to hear it? She grew up in church. She grew up praying. Her family, supposed ministers, she wanted to be a gospel singer till the devil made her an offer. Listen to what she said.
You know, a household where all I ever did was listen to gospel music, and my parents are both traveling ministers, and so I kind of sang about where I wanted to be, like the Amy Grant of music.
Yeah.
But it didn't work out, and so I sold my soul to the devil.
You want to hear it again?
But it didn't work out, and so I sold my soul to the devil.
That girl interviewer's got upside down crosses. Her earrings are. The whole rock and roll industry is hooked up with satanic powers.
Amen.
I mean, some of you Christians ought to check your habit and change your ringtones and your nosebook status. That's where they got it. That's where Katy Perry, that's her role model. Lady Gaga, that's her role model, Madonna. Her songs sound like Madonna's. Listen what Madonna says. Madonna said, I don't care. I don't care. I'm going to do what I want to. I'm an American. We're going to party like it's 1999. Woo! We're going to live it up. And I'm going to tell you something tonight. Hell is an awful, awful place. Ladies and gentlemen, look what ACDC. Satan gets you. Satan gets you. Hell's man. Watch it tonight. Hell is an awful place. Hell is an awful place. Hell is a place. Look at those teenagers screaming. Look at those young people. I can make a fire. And they're burning. Saying, God, let me out. God, help me. God, forgive me. God, help me. God, I don't want to go to hell. God, I'm screaming. God, I'm burning. Look at here tonight, young people. It's too late then. Could you stand the torture? Could you stand the pain? Could you put your faith in Jesus when you're burning in the flame? Ladies and gentlemen, it's too late to put your faith in Jesus then. If you refuse to turn to the Lord, it's hell forever, girls. It's hell forever, boys. It's hell forever, mama. It's hell forever. And it's nobody's fault but yours. You can't blame your parents. You can't blame your mom and daddy for getting a divorce. You can't blame your school teacher. You can't blame your brother, your sister, your husband, your wife. It's nobody's fault but yours. Nobody's fault but yours. And what are you going to do? Are you going to go out of here tonight and say, I don't know about all that. I'm going to take my chances, preacher. Are you going to go out of here tonight and say, Brother Danny, let you hear one more song. The name of this song is Judas. Every kid in here knows this song. And she sings, I'm in love with Judas. Kids, you listen to me. I love you. I'm not trying to be mean, hurt you. Judas is the man that betrayed Jesus Christ. Judas is the meanest person that's ever been on planet Earth. He's the only man in the Bible called the son of perdition. He'll be the Antichrist reincarnated nearly. There's never been a person on the planet done something as bad as Judas Iscariot. So Lady Gaga picks out the person who hates Jesus the worst and says, I'm in love with him. And you got teenage girls all over America going around saying, I'm in love with Judas. Yeah. You've took the wrong side, girl. Listen to some of the words of this song. Watch it tonight. That scares me. I'm scared. See the upside down cross? Even after three times, he betrays me. The king with no crown. I'm a holy fool, but I'm still in love with Judas. I'm a holy fool, but I'm still in love with Judas, baby. That music is addictive. It's like shooting sugar in your veins. America's rocking its way to hell tonight. Now watch this. She says, in the most biblical sense, I am beyond repentance. She can't get saved. Tonight, I want to show you something. And I want you to give me your attention just for a minute. One day the Lord Jesus Christ walking up Calvary's Hill with that cross on his back and on his, and she's singing, "I'm in love with Judas." Kids, look what Judas did. And you sit there and tell me whose side you're going to be on tonight. You sit there and tell me, kids. I hate to show you this and let you hear this in the same context, but I want you to see the difference. That's the world. That's what Judas did. She says, "I'm in love with him." Listen, listen, young people, you claim to be a Christian. Jesus died for you. And she says, "I'm in love with him. I'm in love with Judas." That's your club music. You hear that? That's club music. That's dancing it. That whole spirit done that to your Savior. Jesus died so you could go to heaven when you die. You say, "Brother Danny, that makes me feel awful." Yes, it does, and it should, and it does me too. How can we love the world? That's why the Bible says, if any man love the world, that's why he don't love God. You cannot love this world and love Jesus Christ at the same time. The world crucified him. Sickening. It's sickening. It's sickening. You want to hear something a little better with that? Tonight, I'm glad that somebody cared enough about me to say, "Father, forgive them, for they know not what they do." I'm glad Jesus loved me enough to walk up Calvary's Hill. I say, "Old Danny, he's sorry, and he ought to go to hell. But I love him enough." Hey, you want to be a man? You want to be a man? Stand up for Jesus Christ. You want to be a young lady that people respect? Jesus died for you, girl. If you're decent, you'll say, "You know what? I'm going to straighten up. And I'm going to live for him." Every teenager in this building tonight ought to get a good long look at what Jesus did for you. And he loves you. He loves you. Tonight the Lord loves you, girls. The Lord loves you. I'd get out of my seat tonight. I'd get down here and I'd say, "Oh God." I would. I'd just get out of my seat. I'd get down here and I'd say, "Lord, forgive me. God, work in my heart. God, I don't, if I was here tonight and I wasn't saved, I'd get out of my seat right now and I'd get down here and I'd say, God, I don't want to go to hell. I don't want to go to hell when I die. Lord, I want to be saved. I'd come right now. I would. I wouldn't wait on somebody else. I wouldn't care what my friends thought. I wouldn't care about what they're going to think at school. It don't matter. You stand for the Lord in these last days. You stand for Jesus Christ in these last days. Don't be a wimp. Don't be a sissy. You can't use it for an excuse because somebody's a hypocrite or you know a preacher that ain't what he ought. That ain't no excuse. Jesus is what he's supposed to be. You be what you're supposed to be. Come on. Come on, young people. Let's go. Amen. Come on. Let's get up out of our seats and come right now. Meet me here in this altar. We're going to school tomorrow. Let's go fired up for God. Come on. Come on. That's right. We need somebody to pray. We need some mamas and daddies to pray. We need somebody to pray tonight. We need somebody that can pray and get a hold of God. We need a bunch of soul winners over here. Give me just that one back one back there, Ron. That's good. Thank you. We need some soul winners over here. A bunch of them over here in this corner. Let's do business with the Lord tonight. That's good. You let God speak to your heart tonight. You let God speak to your heart tonight. Will you do it? Will you do it tonight? Will you do it tonight? Come on, Miss Desi. Listen, you come tonight. Come on, young people. Come on, come on. Let's go. Somebody pray with these girls over here. Let's obey God tonight. Let's obey the Lord. That's right. Come on. Amen. I don't want to go to hell. I don't want to go to hell. I'm not by the grace of God. Come on, be a man. Be a man. Stand up for Jesus.